It is so good to be with you on this Sunday evening, the start of a brand new week. And I hope all of you that are seated here this evening are looking forward to God's Word. Because you know what? It doesn't help that we gather and just come and listen to someone that maybe rambles off a couple of scriptures. It's all about the scriptures. Because it's the scriptures that transform us. It's the scriptures that renew us and makes us new and gives us what we need so that we can be sustained on a daily basis. But before we get started, let's just open up in prayer. Father God, we thank you once again, Lord. Again, Lord, we can attest that you have heard our prayers. You have brought us back safely here together again, Lord Jesus, in this special moment. And Father, we just pray that you will be with us, help us, guide us through this service, Lord. And Father, I thank you, Lord, as always, Lord, that I can always say, Father God, that you will watch over the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart, that it will be found acceptable unto thee, our Lord and our Savior. Amen and amen. Calling. That's what we're talking about this evening. Now, you know what? When you start talking to people about calling, then they sort of very quickly, they move to the one side and they'll lift up their hands and they'll say, but no, sorry, I haven't been called and I don't have a calling on my life. If anyone ever says that to you again, please chase them away because they're lying to you. Because tonight through the scriptures that I put together for you, I will show you that each and every one of you sitting here tonight, whether you believe it or not, you've got a calling on your life. Because you know what the biggest thing is when it comes to calling? We see calling only as something that we do in church. In actual fact, calling is something that we are supposed to do outside of church. Because it is so easy to be, let's say it this way. It's so easy to be the light within the light. It's so easy to let your light shine in the church. It's easy. Because all you have to do, you have to come to church, you have to look happy, you have to lift up your hands every now and then, you have to say, praise Jesus, and everyone will believe that you are this happy person and that you believe in Jesus Christ. But it's the moment that we leave, the moment that we get stuck in traffic, the moment that we get to the issues of life, the moment that we get to work again, where our true calling comes to the forefront. And yes, let me just qualify this. Of course, some have been called, as the Bible says, to be pastors and to be prophets. And yes, there is a calling for people to be in church. But do not for one moment believe that you, as a person that does not work at church, doesn't have a calling on your life. It is a lie out of the pit of hell. You do have a calling. Because I always say it this way. I say if there's a plan, a plan equals a purpose, and a purpose equals a calling. So if there's a plan and a purpose for your life, or you should believe that there is a plan and a purpose for your life, because right from the word go, God made man in his own image. God created us in his own image. Each man was created according to the image of God. And you know what, if we look at that scripture in Genesis 1:26-27, it says, then God said, let us make mankind in our image, our likeness. So God created mankind in his own image. In the image of God, he created them, male and female, he created them. Already, you have been created as a specific person. Therefore, God has got a plan for your life and he's got a purpose for your life. And if you don't believe me, you know what, we're going to delve into some of the scriptures this evening. We're just going to open it up for you, hopefully, through the working of the Holy Spirit and not through my words, that you will realize tonight that you have a calling on your life. Now, if we say, you know what, God created us, he created man and woman alike, you know, some of us might then say, okay, but is that all that I've been created for? You know what a special purpose it is to be a man? You know what a special purpose it is to be a woman? There is a specific purpose in that God has created you. And just knowing that you have been created in the image of God should already put something else inside of you to say, but you know what? I have been created for a specific purpose in this life. If we look at what is written in Isaiah 43, verse 1, it says, but now this is what the Lord says. He who created you, Jacob, He who formed you, Israel, do not fear, for I have redeemed you. I have summoned you, by name. You are mine. Does the Lord also not say in the scripture that I knew you before you were formed in your mother's womb? I knew you. But you know what? We look at these, we read these scriptures and we say, but you know, this is not possible. And that is exactly where the problem comes in. Because we make the God of the impossible, we make him as if, you know, this what we read now, he knew us already before we were in our mother's womb. It's impossible. But you know what? With God and in God, all things are possible. And what he's saying in that scripture, he says, but you know what? Before you were even made, I had a plan and a purpose for your life. And if God, the one that has created everything, has a purpose for your life, don't you think that it's time that we need to start stepping into that purpose? Because it's there where you start stepping into that purpose where you realize that there is a calling on your life. And let's go into it a bit. Your calling might not be to stand in front of people and to preach. Your calling might not be to stand on a stage and to sing. But you know what? Each and every one of the ushers that has greeted you at the doors, there's a calling on their life. Because servanthood, and we'll see it in the scriptures, servanthood is most definitely a calling. But we want the, and I'm going to say this carefully now, we want the big things. We want to be seen. We want to be heard. We want to be, but you know what? It's, as I always say, being a pastor is probably one of the most humbling, or should be one of the most humbling things that you can ever do. Because I don't know about any other pastor, and myself and Pastor Louise had a conversation in the week where we said as well, where we said, you know what, it's not about making yourself great. It's not about sounding great in front of people. It's not about being this amazing person. It is all about Jesus Christ. It has always been about Jesus, and it will always be about Jesus. You see, we sometimes we make it and we know that there's a purpose, we know that there's a calling, but then we start attracting people to ourselves, which is wrong. It's wrong. Your calling, or part of your calling as a Christian, must always be just to show people to Jesus. Just to tell people that there is a God in heaven that loves you, that cares for you, that really He's interceding for you at this point in time. That's what the Word of God says. It's part of the foundation of our faith. He ascended to heaven. He's seated at the right hand of the Father. And He is interceding for us. He's praying for us. Why? Because He's got a plan and a purpose for your life. He has called you by name as He called Jacob, Israel. He has called you by name. He says that I even know how much hair you've got on your head. For some, I make the Lord's job easier. I don't have a lot of those, so there's not a lot of counting that needs to be done. Here's the thing, friends. It's time that we realize this calling. It's not this massive thing. It's not going to take up all of our time. It's not going to consume us. But it's gonna cause us to live better lives. It's gonna cause us to extend a helping hand to the people that we get into contact with. It's gonna help us to maybe walk into the streets and go up to that stranger and say, you know what, I can see that you're going through a difficult time or things are not well in your life. Can I maybe pray for you? Because you know what, prayer is a calling. It's part of your calling. How many times do we still see people praying for one another? I mean, we have a prayer meeting every single, and please, I'm not trying let's leave it. But we have a prayer meeting every weekday from 6 until 6:30. And of course, people are busy. They leave early in the mornings. But you know what? At least one day in the week, come and join us while we are praying. Because if there's one thing that I can tell you is that my calling was revealed to me while I was praying. It was while I was in conversation with God, where the Lord revealed to me what He wants me to do and what He needs me to do. And even then, it didn't make sense to me because I said, "Lord, I'm not the one. I am not the one. I think You've got this one wrong, Lord." And I sort of pulled a Moses stunt on the Lord, and I said, "No, this cannot be." But perseverance is one of the things that we get taught very quickly when it comes to Christianity. And it forms part of your calling, because in your calling, you are sometimes going to get to a place where you say, "You know, things are going so hectically wrong in my life. Maybe I have not been called for this." But in and through the battles that you have fought, I spoke to the businessmen in the beginning of the week, and I spoke to them about Benaiah. Such a random story in the Bible, but such a powerful story. The story of Benaiah, we read in the book of 2 Samuel, we read the story, and he says, and he woke up one morning on a snowy day, he went into a pit and he killed a lion. What? How random is that? Waking up, snowing one morning. Okay, so I know there's a lion somewhere in a cave there, so I'm just going to go in there and I'm going to kill him. But it was part of the purpose. Because you know what? In killing that lion, he overcame a battle. And after he became one of David's mighty men, soon after that, he also became the commander of the armies of Solomon. There was a specific purpose for his life. Sometimes we think that things happen in our lives with regards to our calling, and it's so random. But why would God want me now to go to Michael and lay my hand on him and pray for him? Why me, Lord? I'm going to make my name Nana if I... No, just do it. Because it's taking that first step that is going to draw you towards what God has called you to do. And like I said, yes, it might not be preaching sermons, it might not be singing, it might not be, it can be as JP and them does so faithfully, the cameraman does so faithfully every weekend, is to take what God has gifted you with and to use it for no other reason but to glorify His name. Thing is that we need to realize that sometimes our call is to serve and to love others. In 1 Peter 4 verse 10, in the NIV, it reads as follows. Each of you should use whatever gift you have received to serve others as faithful stewards of God's grace. Remember that one. In its various forms. If anyone speaks, they should do so as one who speaks the very word of God. If anyone serves, they should do so with the strength God provides, so that in all things God may be praised through Jesus Christ. To Him be the glory and the power forever and ever. Serving other people can be a calling. You know what? I know of people that started coming to church and like sort of they didn't know what to do first, and they said, "But you know what? I cannot do these things because I don't really like people. I don't really like people. I don't really like being around people." And you know what? All that I can say to all that I could say to that person was, "But you know what? Just continue coming to church." And there where someone reaches out a hand to shake your hand just to greet you, just greet them back. And then, you know what? Start smiling. And it was probably a month into that person coming to church, I could already, and that person couldn't see it, but I could already start seeing the transformation within that person. A smile here and there. And the smile soon became laughter. And the laughter soon became someone that could stand unashamedly with their hands raised high and praising the name of Jesus. And eventually, that person became a missionary. And he was a child of this church. And at this point in time, he took, what happened about a year ago, he took his entire family, him, his wife, and their three daughters. They are living in Japan right now. And they are doing missionary work in Japan. Something as simple as coming to church and smiling and being friendly and helping and being helped transformed that person's life, obviously by the grace of God, so much that they realized their calling in coming to church and said, but you know what? God is sending me to a foreign country. And not just sending me there. I'm going to live there permanently. I'm going to spend the rest of my life there doing what he has told me to do. But don't let that scare you, because, I mean, it's not the same for everyone. Like I said, and I'm not trying to make a call for servants here tonight, but be a servant. Serve people. We said it the other day in the last sermon as well. I said, how many times have you seen, or when last did you see someone helping an old lady across the road with her trolley? Going to the Pick and Pay, and maybe when you see someone struggling to pack their goods into the car. But you know what? We live in a day and age where we have become so focused on what's going on around us. Because, please don't help me. Please don't help me, because you know what? You might be someone that's trying to rob me. It's a fact. It's the times that we live in. But you know what? It should not stop you. It should not prohibit you from doing what God has called you to do. And if you see another person struggling, why not? What bad can come from helping someone in their time of need? You know, we very quickly we say that, you know what, there's never anyone to help me when I need to do something. I always need to do something on my own. I always need to come right up by myself. And wouldn't you like someone to help you when you have a lot of work, or when you have things to do, or where you need to get to a place and you don't have any means to do it? Calling is not just preaching to people. Calling is not just doing things in church. A calling is something that is with you for the rest of your life. And friends, when you realize, when you truly realize what your calling is, the calling that God has placed on your life, believe me, it is one of the most exhilarating things that you'll ever experience. Because there's no effort in that. Because God comes and he reveals, help here, do this, go there. And there where you do it, you get fulfilled. And that fulfillment, yeah, there we must be careful as well, because sometimes it all becomes about ourselves and the self-fulfillment. Everywhere where I see that Jesus went, he didn't think about himself. He always thought about other people. He always took other people's needs into consideration. Is that not what is wrong with this world? Is that not why the world is broken? Because people aren't prepared anymore to go the extra mile, to take the extra step. I saw a young brother, and he's not here this morning. I was running around with the services this morning, and I see this young gentleman every Sunday, and he comes to me, and him and his sister greet me with a very firm handshake. And this morning when I walked into church, I saw him sitting one side, and immediately said, something's not right. I don't know him like this. This is not who he is. And I walked up to him, and I sat down next to him, and I just put my arm around him. And I started praying for him. I said, Lord, I don't know. I don't know what's going on in his life. I don't have to know. But Lord, all that I know is that he needs you now, Lord. And whatever is going on in his life, Lord, I pray for this young brother of mine. And I pray that you'll embrace him, that you'll hold him, and that you'll carry him through this difficult situation. And the young man started crying while I was sitting there speaking to him or praying with him. And when I walked away, I just said, Lord, next week when I see him, let this situation be sorted out. Let his life be turned around, Lord. so that I can see that same warm smile when he walks up to me to greet me with a firm handshake. Let me see that again next week, Lord. And you know what? I believe with everything inside of me, it's going to be like that next week. Because I believe in a God that can do anything, regardless of his circumstances. Prayer, friends, can be a calling. Can be part of a calling. It can be a path that God puts you on, and you start walking towards that what he has planned for your life. Did you hear what I said? What he has planned for your life. Too many times we walk in our own plans. We walk in our own ways. Open your ears. Open your heart. Open your Bible. And start reading. Say, Lord, I don't know. But show me, Lord. Show me the way. Show me what I need to do next. Tell me what I need to say, Lord. Help me to be a better prayer warrior, Lord. Help me, Lord. Because I know that you have a plan and a purpose for my life. Last scripture, 2 Timothy 1 verse 7 says, For the Spirit God gave us does not make us timid, but gives us power, love, and self-discipline. Power, love, and self-discipline. Maybe, just maybe, it's part of God's plan so that you live a self-disciplined life when it comes to reading your Bible, when it comes to praying. Because in that, friends, if you are truly seeking the calling of God on your life, in that, in spending time, in building that relationship, he's going to show it to you. He's going to reveal it to you. And it's not going to be this epiphany all of a sudden. He's going to bring people across your path. There's going to be some difficult things that you need to deal with. There's going to be, just like Benaiah, you're going to wake up in a snowy day and you're going to have to go kill a lion in a pit. There's going to be some things in your life that happens that you don't understand. But it all forms part of the journey, the purpose, the calling that God has for you, child of God. He called you by name. He knows you. What he wants is relationship with you. And let that relationship, and may that relationship, guide each and every one of you towards the very specific and unique calling that he has placed on your life before you were even formed in your mother's womb. Father, we thank you this morning, Lord, or this evening. We thank you for your word that is a lamp unto our feet and a light unto our path. And Lord, there might be some of us sitting here tonight and saying, but I don't know what my calling is. I would love to know, but I want to pray for those people this evening, Lord. And I want to ask, Lord Jesus, that they will grow into deeper relationship with you, Lord. That you will take them to that place where they realize, but this is what God wants me to do. And it might be just going to people and praying for them. It might just be sending a scripture over a cell phone to people that you know. It might just be encouraging someone in a difficult time. I pray this evening, Lord Jesus, that each and every one of us, that we will continue on this journey so that you will draw us closer to that what you have called us to do. That ultimate and unique calling that you have over each and every one of us. You know us by name. You have called us. And we are saying this evening, Lord, please use us as instruments instruments of peace, instruments of love, instruments of care, instruments of serving in this crazy world. Lord, and as we always do, we pray that you will keep us safe through this week. Go on this journey with us, Lord, because we don't want to journey alone. And please return us safely again next week, Lord, so that once again that we can hear the oracles of God. We thank you for your love, your grace, your mercy that is upon us. We plead the precious blood of Jesus over all these wonderful, amazing people here, that you will keep us safe, that you will guard us, and that you will lead us in this week. And for this we thank you in the wonderful name of our Lord and our Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen and amen. Friends, I hope you've been helped this evening, and that the word has spoken to you this evening. And tithes and offerings will be done by Shanae this evening. And we pray that you will, that the Lord will lead you. And that in this, don't even know why I'm doing this, that in this, that this will form part of your calling. Because also the journey that I've been walking with you guys, I've seen how God has transformed you and how he's used you. And how you always make yourself available to do the things of God. May you always be used.